the consultants generated a report to Pittsburgh Public Schools, and there are two, if not three, points that I'm having difficulty understanding, and I might like to get your support and discuss these ideas. Number one, the gifted center is a valuable resource for the city. Number one, it's a legal part of what public education is. The kids have an IEP, they should get some gifted education instruction. And when the gifted program works well, the kids are removed from their home school to a different gifted center, and then that allows the kids that don't leave extra time with their teachers in a smaller setting. So there's a win-win here. It's good for the gifted kids to have a fresh look at things, but it's also good for the kids that stay because they have better access with their teachers and in a smaller group setting. Number one, my kids did gifted throughout, and it need not be something that only the rich kids or the white kids do. It should be something that is innate and that everybody has an opportunity to be tested and to get an IEP. And if you're gifted, you want those kids to stay in town, and you want those families to stay here, and you want them to be excited. Some other districts, I think in Harrisburg even, they have a whole gifted school. So I might even propose that we don't pull the kids out one day a week and send them to the gifted center. Rather, we make an entire school full of gifted kids. Now, it might be a smaller school, a little bit like CAPA's is sort of for gifted for the arts. Well, why not we have gifted for the academics? Okay, we got CMU right here in town too. You know, those are kids that are all gifted and brilliant. Let's make sure that our kids in town get challenged in a great way. So there's gifted education that always has been trying to get knocked aside, and then when they experimented and they did it and it really flopped. And gifted education shouldn't be just a matter of throwing a few extra worksheets at some of the smarter kids in class. Let's keep the gifted education program viable in Pittsburgh. So I'm out to keep that as part of the plan, and I want the board members and the citizens to rally around the idea of gifted education. And if not as it is today, let us expand it. By the way, my father, Leo Rodericus, was a Pittsburgh Public School teacher who spent many years in a teacher center, seemingly wanted to bring those back, and that's great, as well as a teacher in the gifted center. And it wasn't generally here. It was up in the hill, or it was at Woolslayer. They had a gifted center. So I think that gifted centers should be centrally located for easy day transportation. And maybe, you know, and I think where it is now in Greenway is a fine spot, but maybe we need to even do two gifted centers, do an East End gifted center and keep the other one here in Greenway, and have those people come together and get some things. The kids really enjoy it. Gifted education makes Pittsburgh a special place, and I think we should fight like crazy to keep it alive and well. Another point while you're listening is Oliver High School. Oliver is empty right now. You can't even get a pool permit to use the beautiful swimming pool that's there, or you can't use the gymnasium. So this whole thing about, you know, having community access to things is crumbling as a lie with regards to this year Oliver High School. Don't know why, you know. So last year we played water polo there one day a week, and it's a great pool. So we need the community access to that place. But furthermore, what's going to happen to the school? Yeah, there were some bad vibes and some really tragic things happened there that I think our kids that deserve, you know, their own space should be able to use a place like Oliver and have instruction so that they can get an education and Oliver seem to fill a very valuable need for the overall district. And when those kids went to Oliver, they were able to get the small group or individual attention that they needed, and hooray for that. So I wanna see something better described, and that's gonna be a board decision with regards to Oliver High School. Third, what about CAPA? The plan in its first draft called for the removal of grades 6, 7, and 8 from the high school kids. And that makes great sense to us. When CAPA closed Rogers in the East End, Rogers was a middle school for creative and performing arts. Those kids then got absorbed into CAPA. They got a little extra room when that happened, but I think we could get rid of the middle school kids downtown in CAPA and have them go elsewhere, and then that would allow for even more space and more students in high school CAPA. I think downtown high school CAPA should be grades 9 through 12, and then we should have separate middle school CAPA. In the first draft, they were going to go to Manchester. Evidently, there was a lot of pushback on that. Some suggested, well, maybe CAPA middle school could be part of Arsenal. That seems to be centrally located and a nice place to do it. So let's rethink the idea of CAPA having middle school and high school. Let's make solid middle school creative and performing arts. And likewise, if we need to do two of those schools around the city so that the kids in the East and the kids in the West could go to their own little section of a school, fabulous. And then there could be some real auditions with the eighth graders to try to have the talent sharpened so that they can go into high school CAPA, and that can be a little bit more accommodating for more high school kids. Keep gifted. What's gonna happen with Oliver? Let's give those kids their own space. Let's use Oliver as a community resource. And thirdly, middle school CAPA shouldn't be downtown. Expand the high school CAPA instead.